In this video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and stream to YouTube utilizing Streamlabs. Let's go ahead and dive in. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to open up Streamlabs desktop. If you don't have Streamlabs desktop, it's completely free. I'll put a link in the description for you to be able to go ahead and download it. Once you have it downloaded, you're going to come here to the bottom left-hand side and you're going to go ahead and select settings. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and connect YouTube to Streamlabs before we can go ahead and begin streaming. So on the left-hand side, you're going to select stream, and then it's going to go ahead and say stream type. You want to make sure you have streaming services, and then you're going to come to where it says service. You're going to select YouTube RTMPS, and then that's going to go ahead and say primary YouTube ingest server. And then we're going to want to head and get our stream key. So to be able to get our stream key, we're going to want to come over to YouTube. So let's go ahead and do that now. So once you've gone ahead and logged in to your YouTube channel, you're going to come to the top and you're going to select this little camera icon that says create. You're going to select that and it's going to say go live. Once you click that, if you've never live streamed before on YouTube, you're going to get an option screen just like this. It's going to say request access to streaming. Once requested, it may take up to 24 hours to gain access to live streaming. Now, keep in mind that if you do go ahead and get this screen, you are going to have to wait 24 hours before you can even get a stream key to be able to connect it to Streamlabs. And then once you have that stream key, you can then go ahead and continue to follow along with this video. So let's go ahead and get our stream key to connect it over to Streamlabs. All right, so once you've gone ahead and gained access, or if you already have access, once you click that go live button, it's gonna bring you to a screen just like this. And what you're gonna wanna do here is you're gonna see our stream key. You're gonna wanna go ahead and select copy, but before we leave that, we wanna adjust some of the settings here on YouTube. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna change this from low latency to normal latency. This is gonna give you also the best quality, but again, low latency can be the kind of sweet spot if you wanna be able to engage with your viewers in real time. So I recommend normal latency for the best quality, and then here for low latency if you wanna have a little bit faster interaction. Then you wanna go ahead and grab that link that you went ahead and copied there, and we wanna go ahead and go back to Streamlabs. And then we're gonna go ahead and paste that stream key directly in here for us to be able to go ahead and utilize. So once we go ahead and paste it, it's gonna be there. Make sure you don't share that stream key with anyone. Anyone who has access to that stream key is gonna be able to stream on your account. So you're gonna go ahead and hit done just to be able to go ahead and save it. We're gonna come back here to our settings because now we need to make sure that our stream is gonna look good on YouTube. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna come to where it says video. Here, you're gonna wanna make sure that you select and decide whether you're gonna want to have a 1080p stream or a 4K stream. So YouTube is the only platform that allows you to stream higher than 1080p, but it's all gonna be dependent on your internet speed and the gear that you actually have. Now, most people are gonna be watching your stream on mobile, so having a 1080p 60fps stream is gonna be perfect. So that's what we're gonna go ahead and utilize here today. So to do a 1080p stream, you're gonna wanna leave it at 1920 by 1080. Your output scale is gonna be 1920 by 1080. Your downscale filter, you can go ahead and leave it here on that one. And then here, your FPS common values, you wanna put it at 60. Okay, again, all these values are gonna be based on your internet speed. So if your computer can't handle 60 frames per second, you can drop this down to 30 and that should still be fine. So then we're gonna come here to where it says output. This is where we determine our settings that we're gonna utilize to be able to stream to YouTube. This is what determines whether your stream looks laggy, choppy, or the quality of it, how it sounds, how it looks. This is where we're gonna go ahead and customize here. So the first thing you're gonna do is for output mode, you're gonna go ahead and select advanced. Okay, this is gonna give us the most ability for customization to make sure we have a great looking stream. So the encoder, you're gonna go ahead and use X264, or you're gonna go ahead and use your graphics card. I'm gonna go ahead and utilize my software encoder since I'm on a Mac, but this is gonna work even if you're on a Windows. You would just select your graphic card or your X264. Then for your rate control, you wanna have this at ABR or CBR, whichever one is available for you, but you wanna make sure that enforce streaming service encoder settings is checked off. This is gonna ensure that we're able to go ahead and put the custom settings to give us the best quality. And then bit rate, right? This is where we're gonna go ahead and customize now. Now, your bitrate is the most important part of streaming. This is going to determine the quality that you have, and it's all determined based on your internet speed. So I'm going to show you now how you can check your internet speed so that way you know what number you're able to put in here. So let's go ahead and test that now. So you're going to go ahead and come to a website called speedtest.net, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. You're going to go ahead and hit the go button here, and once you hit that go, it's going to go ahead and give you your download and your upload. The figure that we want to focus on is going to be our upload. And what you want here is you want to be able to utilize at least half of what this says here, right? So I have 435 upload, which is more than enough to be able to stream to multiple destinations. But we want to go ahead and go to this link here that's called support.google, and it's going to give you the bit rate based on the speed and the quality that you want. Now, we talked about doing 1080p 60 frames per second on YouTube. So to be able to achieve that, we want to do a bit rate of 4500 to 9000. So to be able to go ahead and get that figure, you need at least in this figure here on upload, at least 18 or 20, right? If you have 20 upload, you can go ahead and do 1080p 60 frames per second on YouTube. And then again, based on your computer there, right? If you wanted to go ahead and do a 1440p stream, then you would want 9,000 to 18,000. And again, whatever this 18 number is, you just want to go ahead and double that. And if you have double of that, you can go ahead and utilize that figure. That is the rule of thumb that I go ahead and utilize. So we can see here that I have more than enough to be able to utilize this. So I'm going to go ahead and utilize right at the tip top of this frame here. So I'm going to come back to Streamlabs. And for my bit rate, I'm going to go ahead and just put it at 9,000 since I know that I can go ahead and support it. Then here for the keyframe intervals, you're going to want to select 2. And then for your profile, you're going to want to select high, right? So now we're going to go ahead and hit done. So now we've gone ahead and connected over to YouTube. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to come here to the bottom, and we're going to go ahead and select go live. And then once you go ahead and press go live, we're going to want to come back here to YouTube. And you're going to see here that we're now live, but your audience and your viewers are not going to see your stream. So to be able to get them to see the stream, you're going to want to click edit. And now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and give our stream a title. We want to go ahead and put a description. This is a great way to be able to put in links and things that you want people to find out about you. And then this is a super important option right here, visibility. You want to make sure it doesn't say unlisted. What that means is that only people who you've given a special link to are going to be able to view that. So you're going to want to go ahead and check that, and you want to make sure this is selected to public. Once you change that to public, that's going to make sure that your live stream is now going to be able to be found. Then you want to go ahead and upload a thumbnail, and then you want to go ahead and add a playlist. So now that you have that in place, that's going to now make your stream visible for the people on the outside to be able to view your stream. And then here inside of your Streamlabs, now you can go ahead and start customizing your scenes, adding your starting soon, your countdown, all your overlays, and everything that you're going to go ahead and need. Now, if you don't have any kind of overlays, you can go to streamdesigns.com. I'll put a link in the description of this video. And then once you have your overlays, you want to go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on setting up all your overlays inside of Streamlabs so that way your stream looks professional. Go ahead and click that video right there to learn how to set them up. See you guys soon.